lithium prices have fallen by over 30% this year, leading some mining companies to stop production and others to scale back future expansion plans. Prices for lithium carbonate are just over $10 a kilogram, down from a record high of almost $80 in late 2022. But have prices now reached a bottom?
Where we're at the moment, the lithium market is definitely very responsive to the pricing level. Interestingly, every time prices have kind of hit $9 or $10 a kilo, there's always been a small inflection back up this year. We've had the same thing at a lot of major price boundaries over the last couple of years, whether that's $60 a kilo or whether that's $15 a kilo. But it does seem to be that there's resistance at the current price level.
This year, falling spodumene prices have led to at least 5 mines to stop production in Australia. Around 15% of planned Australian mine lithium production has been cut from 2025 supply. But that may not be enough supply to come out of the market for prices to rise in the near term.
While a lot of the cost curve is challenged at the current price level, there are still a lot of operations and kind of the big traditional operations that can function economically at the current price level. And then there's also kind of the challenge of strong vertical integration in China, which allows a lot of these players to kind of continue to operate even if that's at a slight loss or at very, very tight margins.
As a result, demand may need to improve in order for lithium prices to rise. Robust sales of electric vehicles in China this year are helping to support prices. Yet outside China, electric vehicle sales remain weak, with sales actually declining in Europe this year.
There are two main things that would drive prices back up. That would be a significant acceleration in demand, which seems relatively unlikely, especially going into Q1, which tends to be a slower quarter for EV demand and therefore lithium prices. The other factor would be supply coming offline. We have had some announcements of curtailments of supply from Australian spodumene majors, mainly those hard rock producers outside of China. Inside China, producers are pressing ahead with production increases as planned, and brine producers are not really struggling at current cost levels either. So overall, those factors are not really pushing us that close to an equilibrium at the moment.
Still, lower lithium prices are having an impact on the longer-term supply picture.
At the moment, prices are too low to incentivize new supply. Our long-term incentive price forecasts are $1,200 a ton for spodumene and $21 a kilo for carbonate and $23 a kilo for hydroxide. If we don't see prices at these levels, then we'd expect the worsening or widening deficit towards the end of the decade to take place.
Benchmark now forecasts that the lithium market could be in a deficit as soon as 2028, from a previous forecast of 2029.
We do see a more balanced market over the next couple of years, but with the price environment and some of the supply side response, we have already started to bring that deficit back towards kind of 2027 rather than the end of the decade.